Hi friends, welcome back to PSDESIRE. Today I will share with you an amazing hack that will make your photo editing super easy and quick. You don't need to be an expert to fix any issues in your photos like lighting corrections, color enhancements and much more. This method is going to help you to create eye-catching photos that will surely stand out. So let's dive right into this tutorial. The photo we will be using today looks quite flat and dull, and the climate isn't doing us any favor either. It's overcast conditions and the colors aren't popping as much as we would like. But don't worry, with the editing hack I'm about to show you, we will be able to turn this photo into something truly stunning. As you know, shooting in a flat profile doesn't give us much color to work with. So we will be using some handy tricks to fix the lighting and make the colors pop in this photo. First thing we need to do is change the color mode to lab color mode. This might seem a bit daunting, but it's actually really easy. All you need to do is go to image menu and choose lab color. This will allow us to work with the photo in a different from the traditional RGB mode. Once we have changed the color mode, we can start to add curves adjustment. This is where the real magic happens. With lightness curve, we can easily tweak the lighting, contrast and clarity of the photo without affecting the colors. And with A and B channels, we can adjust color saturation without sacrificing any of the details in the photo. Taking things one step at a time is always a good approach when it comes to photo editing. It helps you to stay focused and avoid getting overwhelmed. So for this photo, we will break it down into smaller sections: the sky, the subject and the background water. Let's start with the sky. We want to make it a bit darker to create a more dramatic effect. To do this, we will focus on the lightness curve. By dragging the curve down, we can lower the brightness of the sky without affecting the colors or details. It's important to remember that when editing photos, small adjustments can make a big difference. So take your time and don't be afraid to experiment with different settings until you achieve the desired effect. After applying the curves adjustment, it made the entire image darker, which is not what we want. The solution to this issue is to apply the adjustment selectively to the parts of the image that we want to affect. In this case, the sky. To do this, we will use the apply image function. By selecting image from the menu bar and then choosing apply image, we can apply the curves adjustment to specific areas of the image. In the dialog box that appears, we can choose which channel we want to affect, the blending mode and the opacity. So we will make sure that's selected. We will also choose the multiply blend mode, which will darken the selected areas of the image. Finally, we will check the invert box to hide the effect from the highlights. Once we have made those selections, we will click OK to apply the adjustment. Now the curve adjustment will only affect the areas of the image we selected, which in this case is the sky. With this technique, we can fine-tune the adjustments to specific areas of the image without affecting the rest of the photo. When editing photos, we want to make sure that all the elements of the image looks their best. In this case, as we are darkening the sky, we don't want to accidentally make the subject's face look too dark or underexposed. So to fix this, take a soft round brush and set all the brush settings to their maximum level. We want the brush to be as soft as possible so that the effect looks natural and not too harsh. Next, set the foreground color to black. This is important because we want to remove the effect we just applied to the sky from the subject's face and other areas. Now carefully paint over the skin areas of the subject, dress and hair. You will see that the effect of the curve adjustment layer we applied earlier is removed from those areas. You can adjust the brush size as needed to make sure you are only painting where you want to remove the effect. With this simple technique, we can easily avoid any unwanted darkening or underexposure of the subject face while still achieving our desired effect of a darker sky. Great. Now let's tackle another issue in our photo, the lack of contrast. Let's add some contrast to the photo. This will help make it more dynamic and add depth. We can do this by adding another curves adjustment layer. This time we want to use an S-shaped curve. Drag the bottom left point of the curve downwards slightly and then drag the top right point upwards a bit. This will help to increase the contrast in the image. Keep in mind that you don't want to overdo it with the contrast, or the image can start to look unnatural. Remember, you can adjust the opacity of the layer to reduce the strength of the effect if you feel like it's too much. Don't be afraid to experiment and play around until you find the right balance. Now, with a bit of contrast added, we will start to see the photo pop more. The subject will stand out more from the background and the overall image will have a more pleasing look. But wait, we don't want to affect the entire image with this adjustment, right? That's why we need to go to image, apply image once again, but this time we will untick the invert option. This means that contrast will be applied to the bright areas, making them more visible, while it will be less visible in the shadow areas. Go ahead and click OK. Alright, with just few simple edits, this photo changed dramatically. But we are not done yet, let's add some more color and make those colors pop. So let's add another curves adjustment and select the A channel, drag the black slider towards the middle and you will notice the image becomes more green. Now drag the white slider towards the middle and the image becomes more red. Next, select the B channel and repeat the same process, drag the black slider towards the middle and the image becomes more blue, and drag the white slider towards middle and the image becomes more yellow. Play around with the sliders until you find the right color combination that you like. Okay. RGB can be a little complex for beginners to do color shifts, but this technique is easy to use. You can color tone your photos easily using A channel and B channel. It's super amazing how much a little pop of color can do to your photo. To finish up, we will add one more curves adjustment. This time, we want to darken the bottom portion of the photo to create a more balanced composition. So we will lower the curve a little bit at the very bottom point on the curve. Now take a soft brush and hide this effect on the subject's face and dress. We want it to be visible only on the bottom part and behind the subject, so we need to hide it from the subject. It's all about paying attention to the details. And that's what makes all the difference in the final result. Now you can see the incredible difference these two simple edits have made to this photo. When you are happy with the final result, it's time to save the file. You can choose to save it in either PNG or JPG format, depending on your preference. If you do decide to change the color mode back to RGB, keep in mind that this will flatten all adjustments you have made so far. So be sure to save your files in the LAB mode before converting it back to the RGB. So that's it for this tutorial on photo editing. I hope you found it helpful and informative. Remember, taking it section by section is key to achieving the best results in your edits. Adding contrast, adjusting color tones, and hiding effects from certain areas can all make a big difference in the final image. I would like to thank you for watching this video and taking the time to learn with me. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications to stay updated on new content. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and comment. I will see you again in the next video. Take care.